Mass is offered for the following intentions in honor of Our Lady of the Roses, Mary and Mother's wedding anniversary blessings for Melvin and Sabitha Tillis, Dinesh and Colin Shah, birthday blessings for Lorna DeMello, Michael, Itanjali Dasgupta, in thanksgiving. Thanksgiving to Jesus and Mother Mary for favors, various favors received by Arthur Roderick, souls of Mary Fernandez, first death anniversary. Mercy Borges, Carmo, Lasso, Linda D'Souza, Rosie, Oliver, Father Alvaro Nazareth, Neville Suarez, and the deceased members of the Pinto Lobo and Suarez families, Ruby Gonsalves, Trevor, Babs, and the deceased members of the D'Souza and Santana family, Aloysius Darmai, Bernard Pimento, Banifes Pereira, Cyril Francis Castellino, Daphne, Jermaine Dias, Captain Satish Chandran, Julie Anthony, and Peter and Tiago. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
My dear sisters and brothers, we reflect on the words of Jesus. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be open. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to the contrite of our Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to God's sinners, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, strength to those who open you graciously, hear our praise, and since without you mortal frailty can do nothing, grant us always the help of your grace, that in following your commands we may please you by our resolve and our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brethren, since many boast according to the flesh, I too will boast. But whatever anyone else dares to boast of, I am speaking as a fool. I also dare to boast of that. Are they Hebrews? So am I. Are they Israelites? So am I. Are they offspring of Abraham? So am I. Are they the servants of Christ? I am a better one. I am talking like a madman, with far greater labors, far more imprisonments, with countless beatings, and often near death. 5 times I received at the hands of the Jews the 40 lashes less one. 3 times I was beaten with rods, once I was stoned. 3 times I was shipwrecked. For a night and a day I was adrift at sea. On frequent journeys, in danger from rivers, danger from robbers, danger from my own people, danger from Gentiles, danger in the city, danger in the wilderness, danger at sea, danger from false brothers, in toil and hardships, through many a sleepless night. The hunger and thirst, often without food, in cold and exposure. And apart from other things, there is the daily pressure on me, of my anxiety for all the churches. Who is weak, and I am not weak? Who is made to fall, and I am not indignant? If I must boast, I will boast of the things that show my weakness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response is, the Lord rescues them in all their distress. Kindly listen to the tune.
The Lord rescues them in all their distress. Together.
The Lord rescues them. I will bless the Lord at all times. Praise of Him is always in my mouth. In the Lord my soul shall make its boast. The humble shall hear and be glad. Glorify the Lord with me. Together let us praise His name. I sought the Lord and He answered me. From all my terrors He set me free.
The Lord rescues them in all their distress.
Look toward Him and be radiant. Let your faces not be abashed. This lowly one called, the Lord heard and rescued him from all his distress.
The Lord rescues them in all their distress. Alleluia, alleluia.
Together.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
God, who in the offering presented here provides for the twofold needs of human nature, nourish us with food and renewing us with your sacrament, grant we pray that the sustenance they provide may not fail us in body or in spirit. Through Christ our Lord. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere we give thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, His resurrection we confess with living faith, and His coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you as without end.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is He who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray by sending the Spirit upon them, that you cause them to come for us, the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Each time you were betrayed and entered into His passion, He took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to His disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, Chalice and once more gave thanks, gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this for you and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, which is given eternal covenant, poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer the Lord bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks to the worthy to be in the presence of the minister. Humbly we pray that party of the body of Christ be together one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and also with our bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who fallen asleep and hope for resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, his spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant the peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, and I see. Behold the Lamb of God, the only who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof,
but only say the word,
and my soul shall be healed.
Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there. and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. At this reception of your Holy Communion, Lord, who shadow of the union of the faithful in you, so may it bring about unity in your church. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks God.
God is God all the time.